So it's been an exciting couple of weeks. You might recognize that this is a new view. It's because I've been waiting until I had a day off. I could do this in the sunlight. But check it out. Check it out. Check it out. So back a couple weeks ago, I bought this beauty off Craigslist. My dad sent me the listing halfway as a joke, to just sort of be like, hey, look, this is what you needed. You said you were looking for trucks. And oh my God, I love her so much. Eee! Her name's Sandy. I got her for $600, no, $1,600 off Craigslist. So this is an 83 Toyota pickup. Got a few issues. For example, this door doesn't work at all. But the engine runs great. No stereo, so we're gonna have to get that fixed. But it's like a bunch of little things. But the body of it's good, and it's got this rack. Check out the rack on her. Oh my God. I haven't driven in like 3 years, but I got a truck now. I came up with this plan back over the summer, back when quarantine was still in full swing, people still gave a shit. I was sad, I was lonely. I needed people to need me so that they had a reason to try to hang out with me. So I was like, well, when I get my free money from the government, I'm either gonna buy a truck or a gun, I guess. Ended up getting the truck. So it's been just a few weeks of dealing with that. Everything is ship shape. I'm insured. I remember how to drive. It's been absolutely delightful. I had a coworker gift me this hat. So I have a cool hat now. I feel like, let's see, I've got the cool hat, I've got a truck, I've got a long dark green trench coat, and I got a knife. So all I really need now is a flask and my full cowboy, 21st century cowboy aesthetic will be complete. You don't understand. Three flights of stairs. This is the material purchase which will finally make me happy. But it has. I don't know. I do live in the middle of downtown, and we do live in global warming times. So I do feel a smidge bad about going out and buying a vehicle. I mean, I've gotten by just fine the past 3 years without one. You know, only riding my bike everywhere, which is fine and cool. But I mean, let's be honest. I am an American, and there is a certain level of freedom associated with owning your own vehicle. And to make it a truck, well, so we did our first real job today, Sandy and I. Sandy with an I, of course. We did our first real job today. My stepsister moved into a new place, and she got a fridge, a second fridge for the garage, a drinks fridge, which I think is just, that's like a very specific thing to need to have. So she got a drinks fridge off Facebook Marketplace and needed someone to help her move it. And you know what? Guess who you know who's got a truck now? Hey. So I'm, you know, going out there just living my best life, the craziest life. Just, yeah, geez. Oh, what have I been up to since? Can Mountain fell down under its own weight, made a big mess. That sort of put me into a bit of an emotional spiral for a weekend, which we're over now. It's fine, because I have a truck and I'm gonna get all the cans out of my house. I haven't yet because I'm lazy, but but the freedom is there, you know? And I'm making my plans, right? I'm gonna We're going to get our vaccinations. Everyone's going to get their vaccinations. We're going to be moving into the bold new, truly, truly 2020s era. The true, it's not the roaring 20s, it's going to be the screaming 20s. And, I'm freaking ready, you know? I'm gonna get every little thing that needs to be fixed on Sandi fixed, and then we're gonna get a trailer bed so I could sleep in it when I need to, and then I'm gonna save up the money that I can just fucking leave my job for a few months. 3 to 6. Just leave my job, just travel down Route 66, bar hop this nation, and just go south until it's warm enough that I can sleep in my truck, and then east until I hit a Waffle House, and then turn around and come home, because I do. I love my space. I love my crappy little punk flat apartment. I don't want to move that couch again. I like my job as much as anyone's ever going to like a job. Stuff's going good. Stuff's going real good. I did win the Dumbest Bitch in This City award because the day after I bought the truck, I bought Sandi on a Sunday. And I parked it in the parking lot overnight because I figured I would go get my parking pass Monday morning. No. I woke up. I should have parked on the street. I didn't know that. I haven't driven. And especially, I haven't driven downtown and parked and lived downtown with a vehicle, so I don't know this shit. So anyways, point is, I had to go pay $465 to get Sandi back the day after I bought her. So this is a $2,000 truck, essentially. But it's alright. You live, you learn, and that's what we have savings for. yeah. I'm a little ticked right now because the college kids have discovered my dive bar. I felt okay going to my dive bar. I know I shouldn't, but I felt okay going when there was like 12 people there and I knew all of them, but now all the college kids are back in town and they don't have homework yet, so they're out and about, which I guess is their right. It's not their fault, and if it wasn't plague times, then they'd all be drinking inside, and the porch would be for the regulars, and it'd be fine. But right now, it's just like, you just don't get to go to the bar on Fridays or Saturdays. Which is fine, because I shouldn't be going at all anyways. I'm just bitter about it. But that's okay. Because life's looking up and stuff's getting better. That's my update. Stuff's going great, guys. What a world. Oh, this doesn't age like milk. No. The truck's a good idea. No matter what the hell happens to the world, I having it's a good idea. Sandy's my baby. All right, guys. Bye.